very warm welcome to everybody joining us today. I'm Gitanjali Mathur, and it gives me immense pleasure to welcome you on behalf of Zee Business to witness Crypto Spotlight to demystify cryptocurrency. This conclave is being conducted with the aim to bring together various domain experts in the field of cryptocurrency and make people aware of this digital currency. Zee Business takes this onus to educate the audience about the nuances of this very cryptic space through a galaxy of experts who would decode the trends, map the future ahead by proposing various opportunities for readers and investors. We have come to you with three power-packed panels on various aspects of cryptocurrency. The crypto market in India is going through transitional phase, perhaps the most important time for the future of cryptocurrencies, and of course, the people who have already invested tons of money through various crypto exchanges available today. On one side, where investors, young and seasoned alike, are ready to bet it all on the future use and prospect of crypto, the other side tells a different story. With the governments and regulatory bodies such as RBI being cautious when it comes to the use and misuse of the technology. Cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin, Ethereum and Solana has grown in popularity in India and other countries, with the volume of Indian rupees traded in cryptocurrencies at an all-time high since demonetization. According to a research, the volume created by the rupee-dominated cryptocurrency is the third largest traded volume behind the US dollar and the yen. The 2016 demonetization program may have boosted the adoption of cryptocurrencies by a significant portion of the populace, but realities quickly emerged that have hindered the country's market growth. Despite its massive population, India only contributes 2% of the global crypto market. This gives rise to a very pertinent question. If crypto was to be regularized and accepted in the mainstream economy, how will it impact the future of the Indian economic landscape? To make sure we answer all your crypto-related questions and doubts while also educating the public in the process, we are being joined by some of the most notable and sought-after personalities in the world of finance, technology, and regulatory landscape of India. Before we start the crypto discussions through the day, we would like to thank our presenting partner, CoinSwitch Kuber, our co-powered by partners Crypto and BitPNS, and our special partner, PNP Coins, which is also the world's first regulated cryptocurrency. With that, it's time to dive deep into the world of crypto. So without any further ado, let's go straight to our first speaker of the day for a quick fireside chat. So let's welcome Mr. Vaibhav Vats Shukla, co-founder of Crypto, India's finest and leading cryptocurrency platform. Though he started small, Vaibhav has been scaling heights in his career and has done wonders in the cryptocurrency space. Thank you, Vaibhav, for taking out time for us. What are cryptocurrencies and how do they work?
Crypto means secret as a word, right? So cryptocurrencies majorly means secret currency. So the idea behind cryptocurrency, there are no third parties involved in cryptocurrency. So these are digital assets which are only present in computers, right? It does not have any physical form like rupee or dollar or anything else. But they work on a proper peer-to-peer manner, wherein it's basically a person-to-person transaction, right? Without involving any third party. So the underlying technology on cryptocurrencies is blockchain, which is basically runs on a decentralized approach. It means there is no single agency or person or any third party which is controlling the cryptocurrency or its value. So it's controlled by the number of users that are holding cryptocurrencies, and they control the entire value and the entire thing of the cryptocurrency.
Can you tell us more about Let's Crypto?
Yeah, so Let's Crypto, we are creating India's first social crypto trading and payments startup. So crypto allows users to easily and securely buy, sell, trade cryptocurrencies. We are solving the last mile problem between crypto and fiat currencies. At the same time, we are facilitating users with zero trading fees, so they can easily buy, sell and trade cryptocurrencies.
So Vaibhav, are cryptocurrencies safe?
Yeah, so not all cryptocurrencies are safe. There are definitely a lot of fad projects which are going on. So there are, you can say, so many projects which are scams, similar to what you've recently heard about Squid Coin, right? But major coins like Bitcoin, Ethereum, Solana, Matic, all these are pretty much safe, right? They have their own. They've been here for a long time. They have a use case. They have a proper application to their existence. So they are kind of, you can say, are pretty much safe. And in order for you to someone to steal your cryptocurrency, they'll have to get into your computer. I mean, millions of computers at the same time, hack those cryptocurrencies and change the transaction one by one. So which is practically impossible, right? So which cannot happen. So these cryptocurrencies are pretty much safe. But whenever you're putting money in any crypto project, make sure you're properly informed about cryptocurrency and the exchange that you are putting money.
So what checklist should one have before investing in cryptocurrencies?
This question could be looked into two ways. So one is the personal checklist. I mean, you have to be cautious and be curious at the same time. And it's important that you recognize that there is not a complete regulatory framework around cryptocurrencies. It's not regulated, just similar to what stocks are, right? And the market is very volatile. That is the second thing that you keep in mind. You should have some significant risk tolerance. So whatever the money that you have the appetite that basically I can lose this amount of money, you should only put that kind of money into cryptocurrencies. And what kind of, so based on that, you can pool, divide your portfolio into different coins and tokens, whatever you're putting money in. And another thing is basically you have to look at the platform. If the platform is safe, who's the team behind it, who are the investors backing the platform, the number of coins that are being traded on the platform, what are the charges and trading fees and all these things, and how is it generally structured, and what is the technology behind it? Is it safe to put money into it? Is it insured by, say, a third party like Bitco, like we do, right? So do we have these kind of things? I mean, basically you have to do these things. And again, research is, I think, very, very important. You have to make sure that whatever coin that you're investing, whatever exchange that there is, you do a proper research on both these things.
And is it legal in India?
Yeah, so it's very much legal in India. So I think Supreme Court has, in their ruling, they said that cryptocurrencies are very much legal. And RBI recently came up to the banks and said that the banks should provide services to cryptocurrency companies. So there are two aspects. One is as a digital aspect, the digital asset, and second is legal tender, right? So if you talk about the digital asset, cryptocurrencies can be traded legally in India, through the exchanges that we have currently. With that setup, we can basically trade cryptocurrencies. So you want to buy Bitcoin, you want to buy Ethereum or any other cryptocurrency, you can do that. There is another aspect to it, which is basically trading it as a legal tender, right? So you cannot use cryptocurrencies to buy something. So say I want to buy your services or I want to buy something from cryptocurrencies. That is not legal right now. So that is, you can say it's more like in the gray area, not exactly legal. Legal is couldn't be the right word. So it's pretty much in the gray area. It's not regulated yet. So that is where we are at currently. But you can still trade, assets like Bitcoin, Ethereum or any other cryptocurrencies through the exchanges that we have, similar to like Let's Crypto is there, right?
Vaibhav, what's in your portfolio and which cryptocurrencies should one invest in?
I think, whenever you're investing, you make sure you do a proper research on your own before. You shouldn't hear any random tip from the market, you shouldn't read any random tweet and put money into cryptocurrencies. That will not be the right thing to do. But personally, I've invested into Bitcoins and Ethereum. So that's something which is my personal investment. But again, I suggest you that you do a proper and thorough research on the cryptocurrency that you want to invest in. And I will definitely suggest you buy it from Let's Crypto. We have the latest updates, the news and everything, the entire development on the market, what's going on in the market. We have the entire thing on in our app. So you can find info of all the coins in one single platform where you're trading the cryptocurrencies.
So what are the latest trends in the crypto world other than crypto?
I think in latest trends, I think we have a lot of new technologies which have came up. So under blockchain, the cryptocurrency is only a small part of it. So I think NFTs are really important, really new things which have came up. And then metaverse is something which is, there is a lot of development happening around it. Big companies like Facebook, Nike, they have all jumped into metaverse and NFTs. So that's where we are at currently, I think. And there will be a lot of developments in terms of education, the healthcare, politics, I mean, in terms of voting and all these things. I think there could be a lot of development, and blockchain could be a really, you could say, a futuristic technology. I mean, there are a lot of things are going to come into blockchain, and blockchain could change the landscape in so many manners.
So Vaibhav, in your opinion, what's the future of cryptocurrencies in India?
The current the news that we are hearing from the ministry and everything else, NPCI has came up in support of cryptocurrencies, RBI has came up in the support of cryptocurrencies, even a couple of political parties have came up in the support of cryptocurrencies. So I think the future looks really good, and I think we are looking, we're eagerly waiting for the regulatory framework that is coming from the finance ministry. And we are actually waiting for that only. So I think the current signs are looking good for cryptocurrency. And we've seen the highest number of users that are there in cryptocurrencies are from India itself. So I think that's a really good development. And I think it could be a great sign that we are moving into the positive right direction.
Thank you for the wonderful chat, Vaibhav. It has been most informative and interesting to know what you have been doing in this space. And I'm sure our audience has enjoyed this session just as much as us. Thanks once again for joining us on this platform today. So before we move on to the next session of the day, we would like to thank our presenting partner, CoinSwitch Kuber, our co-powered by partners, Crypto and BitBNS, and our special partner, PNP Coins, world's first regulated cryptocurrency. Now let's start with our first panel discussion on cryptocurrency and the world of crypto trading exchanges. Despite the volatility of prices and the legal ambiguity surrounding it, India has the highest number of cryptocurrency owners in the world at 10.07 crores. Evidently, the space holds immense promise. As per latest industry reports, the global cryptocurrency market was valued at $1.49 billion in 2020 and is projected to reach $4.94 billion by 2030, growing at a compound annual growth rate of 12.8% from 2021 to 2030. India is on track to become a digital asset superpower, with retail investors increasingly interested in investing in digital assets. The interest shown by Indian investors in alternative investments and asset classes leads us to believe that the country's retail investors are prepared for the rapid adoption of cryptocurrency as an emerging asset class. India's crypto market is witnessing high trade volumes, not only from the metro cities, but from the entire country. Trade volumes from smaller cities show a high level of penetration of digital assets in India. And with the post-pandemic recovery, retail and institutional investors are looking for high returns on their investments. It looks like digital assets have become their choice to beat inflation. Joining us on this panel as our expert speakers are Shinam Arora, Chief Operations Officer at Wrapped Asset Project. Shinam is an experienced founder with a demonstrated history of working in the computer software industry, skilled in data privacy, ISO 27001, vulnerability management, computer forensics, and digital forensics. Strong business development professional with a BTech focused in computer science and engineering from NC College of Engineering. Our next speaker on the panel is Prashant Saran, former senior financial sector regulator. Prashant Saran has been a career central banker. He headed the banking regulation department in the Reserve Bank of India. After almost three decades with RBI, he joined the Securities and Exchange Board of India as a whole-time member, a position which he held for 7 years till 2016. Joining Shinam and Prashant on this panel is Parin Lathia, co-founder Builders Tribe. Parin is a crypto analyst and writer for various publications on crypto. Parin is also a crypto trader and blockchain enthusiast for over a year now. Traded a portfolio to 20x, ghostwriting a lot of articles on cryptocurrency on Upwork. And last but not the least, moderating this panel is Tejas Shyam, edupreneur, founder and faculty at the Education Journey, entrepreneurship coach, corporate consultant, and twice TEDx speaker. Tejas is a firm proponent of the entrepreneurial mindset. He is involved in several entrepreneurship development initiatives, both as an entrepreneur and as a mentor. So let's hear from this panel on cryptocurrency and the world of crypto trading exchanges.
Welcome everyone to this wonderful panel discussion on cryptocurrencies and the world of crypto trading exchanges. I'm Tejas Somasham and I'm going to be the moderator for this panel. So I'm sure all of you who have tuned in here today are very, very excited about this new buzzword called crypto, right? It's everywhere. It's ubiquitous today. Everybody who is anybody is talking about crypto, be it the doggy coin, be it Ethereum, the common word Bitcoin. Everyone's aware of something called crypto. Crypto exchanges pop up when you watch a cricket match. In today's panel discussion, what we're going to do is we're going to unravel this world a little. We're going to try and understand not only about cryptocurrencies, but more about crypto exchanges. वो exchanges जो आपको अपने advertisements में दिखते हैं जब आप Hotstar पे match देख रहे होते हैं. We have a wonderful lineup of panelists with us today. And I'm actually going to begin this panel discussion with Shinam. Shinam, my question to you is, you know, cryptocurrency, everyone seems to know a little bit about it. But I would want you to tell us a little bit about how is it that these cryptocurrencies are actually created? And, you know, what are the different types of cryptocurrencies that are available today?
We keep hearing about ads, aati rehti, crypto, and people are so keen to invest in crypto, but we don't understand the ABC of cryptos, I believe. So cryptocurrencies are categorized in two ways in terms of creation. So one is Bitcoin style. So Bitcoin, you have heard 2009-10, say we've been hearing about Bitcoins, its uses. Another style that has evolved is Ethereum style. So Bitcoin mostly kya hota hai, if you see, miners are there, you know, all around the world. Aap koi bhi aap ek strong operating system lijiye, connect kijiye main Bitcoin network se, and then you're into it. You can start mining it the day you connect to it. Second is Ethereum style. Usme most of the programming logic aata hai. So I create something called a smart contract. Abhi, they are not really smart. We put in the programming logic to make it smarter, and then we execute and connect it to the main blockchain. So these are how I will identify in terms of creativity. But if you talk about cryptocurrency tokens, I have categorized into 11 types. So one is ready coin, like Bitcoins. There are hush coins. There are open blockchain tokens. There are security tokens. There are asset-backed like Tether. There are plenty of coins. But I believe that before somebody starts investing in it, we need to understand these categories.
Everyone seems to think that crypto is the next big thing. I want your perspective on how do you think this crypto technology is going to change the landscape, it's going to benefit India.
Today, in the last 10 years or so, we've seen crypto industry grow to a couple of trillion dollars in market cap. We've seen large projects like Bitcoin and Ethereum grow by an amazing amount of percentage just by their market cap. Also, we are seeing a wave of innovation that's coming in when people build products on blockchain, which is the underlying technology. So all of this means for India, it means jobs. For India, it means a lot of capital, because all of this research and development has to happen in the engineering field. And thankfully, India is blessed to have a lot of tech talent. We just need to enable them to take advantage of this wave. And also, when we say cryptocurrencies generally, these are apps that we are going to use in 5 to 10 years from now, right? Decentralized apps. India should be the first country to adopt these things. And this just shows how progressive we are when it comes to tech adoption in India.
As our viewers know, आप सबको पता है कि कुछ लोग कहते हैं कि क्रिप्टो बहुत अच्छा है एंड सम ऑफ देम से हे भगवान क्रिप्टो में तो बहुत रिस्क है. There's a lot of you know debate कि क्या ये क्रिप्टो के एक्सचेंजेस जो होते हैं जिन पे आप क्रिप्टो को ट्रेड कर सकते हैं क्या वो लीगल होने चाहिए क्या वो नहीं होने चाहिए. Should the market be regulated? Should the exchanges be regulated or not? And I think the best person to, you know, sort of comment on this and give his perspectives here is Prashantji. Prashantji, my question to you is, you know, to begin off with, what do you actually think of cryptocurrencies as a product in general?
what I understand that cryptocurrency is basically Satoshi Nakamoto's paper. I see it as a part of a larger blueprint. So where the central authorities are decried. They said that, look here, the people are capable enough of managing themselves. Thank you, rulers, so much. We don't want you. We can do very well without you. And the rulers in general are associated with oppression, with exploitation, and all those things. So the Europea, which we see the crypto want to create, is something like that kind of utopia we wanted to create. Well, as a concept, the cryptocurrency and the blockchain technology, it is absolutely, absolutely brilliant. It is one, the first time it was shown that people are capable of managing themselves. We don't need a central bank. Thank you so much. So this was a great idea. And what I feel that cryptocurrencies are as much a statement as it is a product.
मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि एक एक साइड पे अगर हम देखें तो क्रिप्टो करेंसीज की वाह वाह चल रही है, दूसरी तरफ चल रहा है कि यार इसमें निवेश करें या ना करें. शिनम, टेल अस, डू यू थिंक वन शुड इन्वेस्ट इन क्रिप्टो?
आई एम गोना आस्क यू फोर और फाइव क्वेश्चंस. अगर उन सब क्वेश्चन का आंसर यस है, देन यू शुड डेफिनेटली इन्वेस्ट इन क्रिप्टो. अगर उसमें से एक भी क्वेश्चन में यू आर नॉट श्योर अबाउट इट, देन यू शुड नेवर इन्वेस्ट इन. First question, the amount of money that you're putting, are you okay if you lose that money? Second question, are you tech savvy enough ki aap us crypto ko lene ke baad usko safe rakh paoge? Because a lot of times people buy it but they don't know how to keep it protected or safe. It's not like cash that you can, you know, put it in a bank locker. Third thing, are you okay spending some time in researching about these coins? Because you know, you have to research about which coin will go up. There has to be a logic. Are you also okay to wrap around your head that when somebody tweets without any logic, the crypto price can go up and down? Last term, are you okay to learn some new terms like crypto velocity, what is asset-backed crypto? If your answer to all these questions is yes, then you should definitely buy. But otherwise, please do not take the risk. Because it's not worth it. Because I have actually met a lot of people जिनको लोगों ने किसी ने बोल दिया आप इसमें invest कीजिए पैसा double हो जाएगा and this is a fund, they invest in it. They don't know what is private key, public key, should which wallet should they use. So it is a very risky portfolio, I would say.
Parin ji, as I'm sure you are more aware than I am, the central bank today is going to be bringing in digital currency. इन सब की बातें चल रही है. That we have the Reserve Bank, which wants to start off its own digital currencies, right? So, in light of what Shinam just said, you know, she said, look, digital currency comes with its own set of risks. In light of this, how do you see crypto if this CBDC comes in the country, if it's really CBDC, as you know, is the central bank digital currency? Parinji?
Over a period of human history with fiat currency. So just because there is US dollar doesn't mean I don't buy gold, right? It's just something that I want to hold. Similarly, when you were to consider Bitcoin or Ethereum, right now it's time to consider them as simple assets, right? Which people can hold and people can trade in or people can invest in because there's some tech that drives its price up over a period of time, right? So just because there is a CBDC being released, which could be digital rupee or digital US dollar that the Federal Reserve may release, it doesn't mean that Bitcoin loses its value. Right? These two things, fiat currency and any form of store of value that human beings produce, whether it is gold or let's say cigarettes in prison, all of these things exist with fiat currency. So in my view, it would be very clear, you have a digital rupee, and then you can transact with it, just like we do with UPI today. It's actually digital rupee, what we have on UPI. Most of our currency is anyway digital. It's not cash in someone's home or some bank, right? So we are already largely digital. And this just means that when you let people convert rupee to Bitcoin, they will save some in Bitcoin. That's all that's needed. And absolutely, I think the industry welcomes regulation. It's not that this needs to be the Wild West. It has to be regulated, and everyone is working in their own way towards that. But the idea here is that these cryptocurrency as assets fundamentally have some value, and whether it is because of speculation or whether there is some inherent value in the code or the algorithm itself, we don't know. It's just too new for any of us to know at this point in time.
Prashant ji, my question to you is, given that the industry is open to regulations, do you really think regulating crypto is a worthwhile exercise in itself?
Well, the entire issue of the industry wanted to be regulated is something like Barkis saying Barkis is willing and Peggy King keeping quiet. Or rather, her Peggy is protesting. So, ho kya raha hai ki industry keh rahi hai regulate karo. Regulators kehte hai, no, we don't want you. We don't want you to be there. So, that is a very strange thing which is happening. Regulators have got their own worries. They are saying, there are problems of, not able to monitor it completely, and there's a problem of money laundering. There's a problem of black money and all those things. So regulators have got their own worries, and they oppose the crypto exchanges, and RBI had something against it, and Supreme Court said no, you don't do that. So all those things happened. Perfectly fine. Now, I don't oppose it on those grounds. I still oppose it, but I oppose it on the philosophical grounds, on the roots ground, that look here, we started by having no central authority. And what we are saying, please central authority, please regulate us. So this is kind of a contradiction in terms, which is philosophical incongruity, which I don't really like. And the dream, to me, it's slightly betrayed. If we go in for regulated crypto exchanges, then the next part is this, that it has spawned a new animal, which is CBDC, Central Bank Digital Currency. Now, with cash, the general public had some refuge, somewhere to go, where nobody is following it. If I go and buy a toothpaste, nobody knows it. So there's some privacy left somewhere. With CBDC, even that last vestige of privacy is lost forever. So what has happened? The dream has not only been betrayed, it has soured beyond the recognition. So I don't appreciate regulated crypto exchanges. Rather, conversion into fiat currency itself is against the basic principles of the cryptocurrency, where we don't want central authority.
कहीं ना कहीं हमारे जो दर्शक हैं उनको एक दो चीजों पे शायद थोड़ी सी clarity मिले तो बेहतर हो. So I want Shinam actually to come in here. Shinam, we've been talking about regulation, right? We've been talking about exchanges. I think we heard the word centralized, decentralized some time back. I just wanted a quick, perspective from you for our viewers, for their benefit, ki ye centralized or decentralized exchanges kya hain aur ye kaam kaise karte hain.
Centralized exchange jo hai wo ek bank ki tarah hi kaam karte hai. You use it as a typical bank example. Centralized exchange mein you have to get a KYC done. They follow proper rules and regulations. You have to, you cannot use credit cards as of right now in India to put in money. You have to prove your ownership that, this is the same person that who's submitting the documents. All that comes under centralized exchanges. But centralized exchange mein risk kya hai ki kabhi kabhi overnight exchange band ho gayi. Bahut sare cases hue in over the period of years. Bank exchange will just send you an email ki please aapka crypto nikal lijiye. Hum log band ho rahe hain, hamare operations are shutting down. And if you miss that email, your crypto is gone. And there is a risk in centralized exchange. Hacking ka zyada risk hai. So the ads that you see are all centralized exchanges. Koi anonymity nahi hai. The concept of crypto started with anonymous, that you know, you don't know who's owning that crypto. But centralized exchange mein sab kuch open hai. Matlab, you know ki Sheena Arora ka ye account hai, she owns this much crypto. That is happens in centralized. But we also believe in the concept, not your key, not your crypto. Because centralized exchange mein, they hold your key to your account. क्रिप्टो में क्या होता है, दिस इज की दैट यू हैव टू डाउनलोड. सो अगर वो की मेरे पास सिस्टम में डाउनलोडेड है, दैट मींस आई कैन प्रूव द ओनरशिप कि ये टोकन्स मेरे हैं. पर अगर वो की मैंने गलती से आपको दे दी, यू नो यू हैव एक्सेस टू माय सिस्टम, आई कैन नॉट प्रूव कि ये मेरा पैसा है या मेरे टोकन्स है. डिसेंट्रलाइज में नोबडी नोज हु ओन्स इट. डिसेंट्रलाइज में एक फीस नहीं है. सेंट्रलाइज में अगर आप अभी आप जो एक्सचेंजेस की एड्स आप सुनते हैं, अगर आप देखेंगे उसमें, अगर आपको एक्चुअली पैसा विड्रॉ करना है फ्रॉम दैट एक्सचेंज टू योर फिजिकल हार्ड वॉलेट, दैट मीन्स यू विल हैव टू पे अ बिग अमाउंट ऑफ फी. बट डिसेंट्रलाइज में फी इज वेरी लिमिटेड. दे डू अ ट्रेड वाइज फी. दे डोंट दे पुट यू कि अगर आपको कितना पैसा निकालना है उसके परसेंटेज में. सेंट्रलाइज में फिक्स चार्जेस रहते हैं कि अगर आपको पैसा निकालना है एक्सचेंज से, दिस इज वॉट इट इज. सो आई वुड से कि इफ यू आर इन्वेस्टिंग योर मनी फॉर अ लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, आपका इंटरेस्ट अगर क्रिप्टो में इन्वेस्ट करने का है कि आपको लॉन्ग टर्म में गेन लेना है, देन प्लीज पुट इट इन अ डिसेंट्रलाइज्ड एक्सचेंज. बट अलोंग विद दैट, प्लीज बी एजुकेटेड अबाउट व्हाट इज दिस की का कॉन्सेप्ट, हाउ डू यू डाउनलोड इट, एंड हाउ डू यू कीप योर कंप्यूटर सिक्योर व्हिच ओन्स दैट की.
परी जी, हम लोग इस चीज के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द फैक्ट दैट यू नो देयर आर एक्सचेंजेस रेगुलेशंस एंड सो ऑन, बट ऑन द अदर हैंड हमारे पास ऐसे बहुत सारे स्टार्टअप्स हैं जो आजकल इस क्रिप्टो स्पेस में आ रहे हैं, एंड आई एम श्योर यू नो गिवन द क्रिप्टो बूम एवरीवन फील्स दैट इट्स अ ग्रेट टाइम टू डू समथिंग इन द क्रिप्टो स्पेस, राइट? दिस आई एम टॉकिंग ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑल आर यंग एंटरप्रेन्योर्स आउट देयर. व्हाट डू यू थिंक द अ यंग क्रिप्टो स्टार्टअप इन इंडिया नीड्स from the Indian regulatory system, you know, because in view of what Prashant ji said, ek taraf wo hai regulators jo keh rahe hain ki look, we don't want to touch this with a barge pole, and ek taraf crypto startups are saying look, hame regulate kariye in some way. So what according to you is what our young startups need?
From startups perspective, hamare paas bahut talent hai India mein. Young logo ko crypto automatically samajh aata hai. They are very savvy in their own sense. And there are opportunities to build the next Google, next Facebook in Web3, जिसको हम बोल रहे हैं, जो cryptocurrency पे based economy है, जिसको हम Web3 बोलते हैं, right? So there is a large scope here. उस scope में essentially as a founder, what they need is certainty. कि certainty है that you know you don't have any threats against you. You won't be basically harassed or, you know, not allowed to do business in any way. That's the first thing that is needed from the government side. Second thing that's absolutely needed is to find ways to regulate this. Singapore has a sandbox model, you know. They generally discuss more with stakeholders. And I think the government has just started doing that now. That's a positive step. From the industry side, there have been positive steps. And eventually, when these things get solved, we want India to produce, you know, 10 unicorns every year. When that happens, that means that much more capital, that much more edge that India has. And probably crypto is the only field where the tables have turned. Countries that have talent are benefiting, which means from India, we can build products that are being used by global population. Till date, we had our Flipkarts, we have our Zomato and Swiggy, but they are limited to India in certain ways, right? So this is our chance to say, hey, let's build products here and export it to the world. And Indian engineers that get into Web3 can build products like this. So that's the big opportunity that lies in front of us.
Parin ji, we've been talking about cryptocurrencies and tokens. Is this all about crypto token trading, or is there something more to this apart from, you know, the tokens and coins? Is there all that there is to it, or kuch aur bhi hai crypto mein jo hum explore kar sakte hain?
Most of the hype is taken by price talk, right? Bitcoin went to this price, and Ethereum went to this price, and Dogecoin went to this price. All of these things overshadow the larger fact that blockchain still holds true, right? Today, industries are implementing blockchain in ways that we can't imagine right now. Generally, I say that, you know, compared to internet, we are in like 1995 of internet, right? Blockchains are yet to mature. Real use cases are yet to come about. And this is where the real value lies. Most of the token launches eventually go to or should go to research, right? They may or may not. There is a ton of speculation in the market. But eventually, a lot of this money lands in hands of people who are building this decentralized infrastructure. And who wouldn't want, let's say, a decentralized WhatsApp tomorrow? We would want it, right? It's good for our privacy. It's good for us controlling our own information. It's good for transparency. All of these things are being overlooked, mostly because everything just revolves around prices. But the underlying technology and the startups that are working on it are doing a commendable job, especially in India. And I think the global stage is ready for us to grab this opportunity.
ये जितने भी coin wallets आप देख रहे हैं, मतलब there are ads of a lot of different kinds of wallets that come in, etc. What kind of a wallet do you think we should use if at all we are going to go in for cryptocurrency?
I believe that crypto is here to stay, yes. It is an asset class. So I believe that wherever money goes, crime follows. So that is why I'm saying that everybody can see crypto itna badh raha hai, aisa full speed pe grow kar raha hai. So do you really think criminals don't see that? They are also seeing it. And for them, the easy target would be people jinko, you know, they invest, jisne kisi ne bol diya. For example, a lot of people have come to me also that we want to buy some cryptos. Why don't you give us 5 names or 6 names? That is like, they just want to believe somebody on hearsay. So I believe that that is an education part which we should bring in for people. Jaise exchanges add karti hain with big stars ki invest in this, I believe that they should take a step forward to educate the customer. Lot of people, old age people, they can't even use Google Pay. Like, how do you expect them to give PPF pura funding, the PPFs and everything to invest in a crypto because somebody tells them, main ek mahine mein paisa double kar dungi. And I trust me, I've met those people who claim that they can double your crypto investments in a month. So there I want people to be cautious. And in terms of how to keep your crypto safe, there are different kinds of wallet that comes. Hot wallets and cold wallets. So hot wallets, as the name says, they're not actually hot. I'm sorry for the joke, but it means they're actually connected to the internet 24/7. And whenever anything is connected to internet 24/7, it is more likely to get hacked. So that is where hot wallet comes in. So that is perfect for people jinko subha jinhone, you know, Matic mein invest kiya and sham ko they would withdraw just for the everyday gains. So that is perfect for people those. But the second concept comes is a cold wallet. Cold wallet are not connected to the internet. They give you a seed phrase or sometimes automatic jise OTP aata every time when you try to do a transaction. Similarly, cold wallets mein it's a pen drive that you can get. They give you a random number generator. So you will get an OTP that you will have to log in to enter into that. So that is for a long-term investment. So, you know, aaj main invest kiya, maybe for my other set of generation that I want to keep that crypto, or maybe for 5-6 years down the line. That's when we use a cold wallet. So I believe that depending on what is the agenda that you are investing in crypto should decide where you should keep the money.
Prashant ji, your final verdict. Do you think you should actually completely abandon cryptocurrencies, or do you think nahi, crypto ka bhi koi future hai? It's something that can, you know, probably sustain and grow. Because Chinam said she thinks crypto is here to stay. I thought we'll close with your verdict. What do you think?
There are excellent uses of cryptocurrencies, non-fungible tokens, definitely yes, smart contracts, definitely yes, and as Parin said earlier, the field is unlimited. Blockchain technology is a wonder. It's a brilliant idea. So there is no way of throwing baby with the bathwater. So baby is to be kept.
I think it's been a great conversation with three extremely knowledgeable and talented people, and I've learned a lot in this conversation. मुझे ये आशा है कि आप सब भी इस चर्चा से बहुत कुछ सीख चुके होंगे. आप सबको भी क्रिप्टो की इस दुनिया में उसकी एक छोटी सी झलक दिखी होगी. आपको क्या करना चाहिए, what are the things you should avoid, इन सब चीजों से आप अवगत हो चुके होंगे इन पिछले 30 मिनटों में. इसी उम्मीद के साथ कि ये जो क्रिप्टो की लहर आने वाली है आप सबको भरपूर खुशहाली प्रदान करे. इट मेक्स एवरीवन द नेक्स्ट मिलियनेयर्स. दिस इज तेजस सोमाश्याम साइनिंग ऑफ ऑन दिस पैनल. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर बीइंग द वंडरफुल ऑडियंस एंड थैंक यू पैनलिस्ट्स फॉर योर अमेजिंगली वंडरफुल इनसाइट्स इनटू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ क्रिप्टोकरेंसी.
Thank you everyone for this wonderful and informative discussion. I'm sure our viewers have learned many new terminologies and facts about the crypto trading from this panel today. These are the kind of discussions that we all strive for. Now let me thank our sponsors of the event before going on to the next session. Presenting partner CoinSwitch Kuber, our co-powered by partners Crypto and BitBNS, and our special partner PNP Coins, world's first regulated cryptocurrency. So our next panel discussion is about global crypto trends and the Indian crypto market. Notwithstanding the legal ambiguity on whether cryptocurrency investment is permitted in India and huge volatility in prices, the country has the highest number of crypto owners in the world at 10.07 crores. The US came in a distant second in terms of crypto owners at 2.74 crores, followed by Russia at 1.74 crores and Nigeria at 1.3 crores. In comparison, the number of stock investors, unique client codes registered with the BSE in India has risen from 70 million in June 2021 to 80 million at present. According to a data by the exchange, in terms of the number of crypto owners as a percentage of the total population, India stood at the fifth spot at 7.3%. Ukraine ranked first with 12.73% people of the total population owning crypto, followed by Russia at 11.91% and then Kenya at 8.52% and then the US at 8.31%. These are the findings of a study conducted by a portal's annual Crypto Proliferation Index. The digital assets have caught everyone's attention, not only because it has emerged as the best asset class of 2021, but also because other asset classes are not able to fulfill the aspiration of the smart investors who want their money to grow in tandem with global growth rate. Apart from metropolitans, a lot of users are young from tier 2 and tier 3 cities in India who are trying to get into crypto as the first investment class. One trend that has been consistent around the globe is that younger people are leading the charge when it comes to cryptocurrency adoption. Young people between the ages of 18 and 34 make for more than 40% of users throughout the world. Studies show that the adoption of the crypto market has grown by over 88% between June 2020 and June 2021. Worldwide, and the number of crypto users in India has crossed over 15 million during this time. Joining us on this panel, we have Srinivas Mahankali, Chief Business Officer, Blockchain for APAC at Secure Cloud. Srinivas Mahankali leads the blockchain practice for Asia Pacific region for the BSE listed cloud specialist company, Secure Cloud Technologies Limited. He is alumnus of India's premier educational institutions, IIT Madras and IIM Bangalore, with over 30 years of industry experience. He has authored several books on technology like Blockchain, The Untold Story, Blockchain for Non-IT Professionals, Blockchain and Smart Cities. He also co-authored books like Secure Chains, Cybersecurity and Blockchain, AI/ML Powered Agents of Automation, Blockchain Consortiums and Business Model of the Future, etc. Our next speaker on this panel is Advocate Puneet Bhasin, International Cyber Law Expert, Privacy and Data Protection, and GDPR Cyber Crimes. Advocate Puneet Bhasin is a pioneer in cyber laws in India and awarded the Best Cyber Lawyer in India. She is an advisor to the Rajya Sabha Committees on Internet Laws and a recipient of 5 national awards for contribution in cyber laws, one of them being Best Cyber Lawyer in India, from late Sri Ram Jethmalani. Ms. Puneet launched CyberJur Academy in 2018 to develop industry skill sets in EU GDPR compliance, cyber laws, cybercrime investigation and data protection compliances, and till date has trained over 400 CXOs and professionals. With over 400 plus clients globally, she's among the most sought after and trusted lawyer in the cyber laws and privacy matters. Joining Srinivas and Puneet on this panel is Adhiraj Gupta, CIO at the Stealth Startup and President at Impact Launchpad. Adhiraj's passion lies in creating and running startup experiments to explore a spectrum of opportunities and industries, including financial markets, banking, finance, payments, blockchain, healthcare, and any tech that changes our future as a species. Adhiraj is funding and developing a not-for-profit financial infrastructure venture, which aims to create a connected financial system that can enable impact to flow and be delivered at scale. He's also supporting nations, states around the world in building economies using technology, communications, investment, and infrastructure projects. Adhiraj is also working with his team on developing a new model for finance using an iteration of the war bond. Concept evolved to create an impact bond and an impact finance ecosystem. And moderating this panel is Tejas Shyam. Let's join our speakers in this extremely exciting panel discussion. Over to you, Tejas.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to this panel discussion on global crypto trends and the Indian crypto market. I'm hoping you guys are as excited as I am today to do this panel discussion with our August set of panelists. It's a wonderful time to be talking about crypto, and it's a great panel that we have here with three very eminent personalities. We're going to be discussing a lot about the Indian context and the global context of crypto. Without any further ado, let's throw open the panel discussion. So my first question is for Srinivasji. Srinivasji, blockchain, crypto, these are words that we're hearing very often these days. How do you think crypto can benefit India specifically?
You know, we always think about blockchain versus the crypto. Cryptocurrencies and tokens and coins and all these things. So India has been very bullish on blockchain as such. But in terms of cryptocurrencies and all the other derived coins and other assets, whether you call STO or all the ICOs or whatever, they're not so much welcome as of now in India. Though India does not prohibit use of all these things. So in terms of how we can it can benefit, I would say the biggest benefit for India is that I'm seeing is that India is the backyard of any innovation with respect to information technology or cutting edge technologies. So all these technologies require intellectual capital, and India has got immense capital as such. So I feel that whatever developments are taking place in this, which are all, sort of digital assets, have a huge, impact for, offer a huge potential for India to participate and develop, as a superpower in the IT space and the emerging technology space. So definitely that way I will feel it's very much advantages.
What is the legal status of cryptocurrency in India? And this is where I want to bring in Puneet into our discussion. Puneet.
From the perspective of whether cryptocurrency is legal in India, you need to understand there is no form of legislation regulating or legalizing the sector. The only statement that has been given is it's not prohibited, which means you can play, you can have interactions, or you can have exchanges. You will have to pay income tax on the same, but if you're talking about it being a legal tender or a currency in India, it is not. There isn't any form of legislation which is regulating it right now, which also means that if something goes wrong, there is nobody who can be held accountable for the same. You will be basically filing cases only under the Indian Penal Code. It's not regulated by the RBI. It's absolutely unregulated, and it comes with a very huge disclaimer of all the risks possible in this moment.
Given all of this, do you still think it is important to hold crypto as an investment in your portfolio? And if yes, why?
मेरे हिसाब से बहुत जरूरी है actually. And the reason for that is because if you think about what's happening in the investment and the stock markets, right? Like if you think about what's happening gold, for example, in the last 10 years, gold returned negative interest rates, negative returns. You know, we have a bubble with the property market, we have a bubble with the stock markets. And so crypto becomes one of those places where you can actually keep some money, a small percentage of your wealth, and make sure that that will actually return you a positive return. And to give an example, you know, the US dollar in the last year, the US Federal Reserve has printed 40% of its money supply in 1 year. So if you imagine what inflation it will be for the US dollar, and every country is doing the same, India is doing the same, New Zealand is doing the same, Australia is doing the same, and a lot of these countries have done this because of COVID, it means that the money supply is going, right? 5 साल पहले जो आप 100 रुपए में खरीद सकते थे राइट वो आज 1000 रुपए की चीज हो गई राइट सो द रीजन क्रिप्टो इज इंपॉर्टेंट इज बिकॉज दैट सेम बिटकॉइन अगर आपके पास एक बिटकॉइन पहले था तो जो एक बिटकॉइन में आप खरीद सकते थे आज वो एक बिटकॉइन में आप घर खरीद सकते हो राइट तो इट्स समथिंग दैट एज एन इन्वेस्टमेंट मेक्स सो मच सेंस
श्रीनिवास जी हाउ डू यू थिंक इंडिया इज पोजिशनड to take advantage or how do you think India is positioned in this entire global ecosystem of crypto to be able to leverage crypto and make it big?
There's a fundamental problem that most of the governments and you know a lot of organizations they have with respect to calling this particular crypto asset class as currencies, because currency is something that has got certain sanctity and it is backed by governments, and also, you know, it stands against certain assets, you know, it's backed by certain assets of this government. So what happens is when you call this currency, you know, it raises a lot of questions and people get, you know, ruffled a lot, especially in the, you know, the traditional financial domain. So, but there are different types of cryptocurrencies, crypto assets, whether you call it whether tokens or STOs, which is security token offerings, or you know, or NFTs. Like this, there are you know, private coins. So many different types of cryptocurrencies. And the latest, I think, the crypto adoption is going to happen in the form of central bank digital currencies, which a lot of governments have started, you know, experimenting. And India is likely to definitely come out with its own central bank digital currency and a blockchain. So that's where I feel, you know, all this, you know, whether Bitcoin is going to be becoming a mainstream currency like how El Salvador has accepted today, but none of the other countries have, in my opinion. Everybody has accepted it to trade in Bitcoin as an asset class, wherein, you know, you understand the risk that if something goes wrong, you cannot, you know, do anything. You have to, you know, blame yourself for it. As long as it's going up, it's fine, and the way it fluctuates, it would put even the wildest of the shares to, you know, shame, because, you know, a currency wouldn't do that, you know, and it is not backed by any asset as such. It is only, everything depends on, you know, rumors as well as what Elon Musk is saying about it all.
So Puneet, my question to you is this, you know, crypto companies today, in fact, are advertising on social media actively, and now they've also probably even switched to television, you know. Given that this is happening so frequently, is this legal? Or is this something that they're doing on their own initiative? And if it's not legal, right, is this something that augurs well for the domain of crypto, or do you think it's going to be counterproductive for crypto in the long run?
So I would say, see, first of all, when you are having any form of advertisement, it has to be absolutely informative about every aspect. Now, over here, there are a lot of terms and conditions attached. So some of the advertisements on social media, if you will see, even on OTT platforms, they simply have some or the other actor promoting cryptocurrency or an ICO that's going to be coming through and saying, if you invest today, you can end up buying a car tomorrow with this money. If you invest today, tomorrow, you can become a millionaire. Now, all of this, we have Indian masses. जो आम आदमी है वो पहले तो क्रिप्टो करेंसी की वर्किंग नहीं समझता उसको ये समझ नहीं आने वाला है कि ये कैसे अप्रिशिएट होगा, कैसे गिरेगा. आम आदमी क्या सोचेगा, अच्छा चलो मैं 40-50 हजार आज इन्वेस्ट कर दूं तो क्या पता मुझे 1,00,000-1,00,000 मिल जाए. सो वी आर लुकिंग एट मासेस हु आर नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग द लेवल ऑफ रिस्क, एंड द रिस्क इज ऑल द एस्टेरिस्क्स बिलो एंड द टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस, इन्वेस्ट विद केयर, एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा, व्हिच द कॉमन मैन विल नॉट अंडरस्टैंड. So in these kind of advertisements, the truth is the risk is very heavy that you are reaching out to a market which really is not educated about the subject and about the risks either. So to a great extent, yes, a regulation of such advertisements is needed, either which have full informed information for a user, and they cannot be luring people into something without a clear background idea given to them of the inherent risks in the same.
Adiraj, I wanted to ask you, you know, how do you see global trends in crypto across the board despite all of these challenges? Do you see something exciting happening there? What's happening there?
Yeah, what Puneet said is absolutely right. You know, whenever making an investment in the crypto space, understand what you're investing in and what that looks like. And also my advice is always stick to Bitcoin, stick to Ethereum, stick to the more common public chains rather than ICOs and IDOs, because there is a lot more risk involved with them. But to answer your question, the space has changed a lot. So I've been in the crypto space for 5+ years now. And, you know, in the early days, it used to be a space where there was a very small group of people. Everyone knew each other. Everyone knew who was doing what project. Today, it's a whole world, right? Like, even Facebook is entering in the crypto space. Nike just entered in the crypto space. You have all the big companies. Apple is hiring people to have engineers in the crypto space. And so we're at that inflection point where it's no longer about, you know, will you do something in the crypto space? It's how will you do something in the crypto space, and what will you do in the space? And it's more a question of which cryptos and which blockchains will last that duration and which major companies will enter into the space, rather than will crypto survive. It's very much a how will it thrive in the future and what will that future look like, rather than, you know, is this something that will exist 5 or 10 years from now? It's already here and it's here to stay. How it stays is the interesting question.
Srinivasji, how do you think India can speed up the blockchain adoption by involving a multi-stakeholder approach? What is your mantra for this multi-stakeholder approach? Aapko kya lagta hai?
I mean, though government has been taking calculated moves, now the time has come wherein it cannot delay any longer. It has to take the bull by the horns. It has to, you know, cast its vote this way or that way. Because if you're not doing it, and suppose if you don't want, you know, to regulate it, and say that it is illegal tender or anything to do with this domain is illegal, then the speed at which is growing, the people are going to be exposed more and more. And one fine day when government pulls the plug, like how it did in demonetization, people would be, you know, deeply affected. So it has, and if it says it is legal, and you know, some of the parts of it are legal, and if it is able to take the put in place the regulation, whether it is and also give a roadmap for central bank digital currencies or permission the blockchain tokens, or any of the security token offerings like this, if it says okay, these are the things that are legal, you can go ahead, and we are putting in place a blockchain regulatory development authority or something like that. Now you can, you know, that will help a lot of innovation flourish, has always been happening all over the world. And as far as Bitcoin, Ethereum is concerned, world over, nobody is agreeing for the term cryptocurrency. They're saying it is some sort of a, you know, asset, but it is not a currency. So you can invest it as if how you're thinking of, you know, you're investing in some sort of an asset with all the risks, knowing fully well all these risks are there, and you pay the taxes as if you earn some gains, capital gains. That is the way everybody has been saying, and perhaps if it is able to come out with some sort of a guidance for that, either do it or don't do it, or if you do it, if this is the way to do it, and then these are the things, risks that you have, and I'm not responsible for the risk, because it's very difficult to pinpoint accountability in permissionless blockchain ecosystems.
फ्रॉड नहीं हुआ तो बहुत पैसा है. देयर इज लॉट ऑफ मनी, देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ गुड स्टफ दैट्स गोना हैपन टू अस. व्हाट इफ देयर इज अ फ्रॉड? अगर हमारे साथ फ्रॉड हुआ तो फिजिकल पैसे में वी कैन गो टू अ पुलिस थाना, वी कैन गो एंड कंप्लेन टू सम अथॉरिटी, राइट? बट इन केस ऑफ अ क्रिप्टो ट्रांजैक्शन एंड एक्सचेंज फ्रॉड, व्हाट इज आवर लीगल रिकोर्स? पुनीत.
Well, in the last 5 years, we have worked for multiple cases, filed police complaints. You need to understand, not a single FIR has been registered in all these kinds of crypto-related scams and frauds. The reason being, first of all, evidence. The kind of evidence that has to be produced, even to the police has to understand that evidence. They also have to be abreast with everything. So there, definitely, it is very difficult to even get them on the same page to understand there is a crime. You need to understand the provisions of the Indian Penal Code apply. So which means you have to go to your nearest police station and file a police complaint there. Your nearest police station police officer has to understand what has happened with you. All the evidence that's going to be there is going to be digital evidence having a digital trail. And you need to have valid evidence which is even admissible under the Indian Evidence Act and evidence which the police can rely upon to file an FIR. Too many ifs and too many things that should be there. And that is one of the key reasons where if you will see our statistics, the number of cases and frauds that have happened in India are very high, but the number of convictions are practically not there. And if you will see the number of FIRs, they are minuscule really. So you need to understand the amount of legal recourse, even if you have all the financial resources to hire the best of lawyers. The legal recourses available to you from a very practical perspective are very minimalistic. You are working with an ecosystem that also has to understand cryptocurrency. Then the judges have to understand it. The police has to understand what has happened to you. We have seen cases of fake exchanges and it's very clear what has happened to an individual, and it has been very difficult to register an FIR in such cases. Because a fake exchange, how are you going to prove it that it is fake? How are you going to have that form of evidence? Normally, these exchanges will say, oh no, the market fluctuated, especially if it is not a well-known cryptocurrency. There are people, lakhs of people at one shot who have lost their money. And here it is unregulated. Who determines when it falls? That is the big question. Today, if a person loses money, he calls it a fraud. If a person gains money, he calls it an asset. The day you lose money, you say, oh, I have been cheated. Whereas the organization which has issued the coins to you or the exchange over which you've been exchanging it, trading it, they will simply say that's a market situation. So how do you think the police would be able to register an FIR in this? What will a magistrate or a court really look into this? The kind of evidence required for legal recourse will not be there. So I hope I'm able to convey to you, Tejas, what I mean. कि इसमें आप क्या बोलोगे? मार्केट सिचुएशन चेंज हो गया, इस वजह से पैसा नहीं मिल पाया आपको. अब इसमें पुलिस आपको क्या बोलने वाली है? It's very dicey. So the legal recourse, practically you have nothing much unless all the lakhs of people who have lost money in one particular organization, you know, kind of file a class action suit, which is not an easy task also.
So you've had enough of discussion on the challenges. I want you to tell our audiences, I want you to tell them why and what are the positive impacts of crypto across the globe, so that, you know, we all leave with a nice holistic perspective on, yes, there are pitfalls, but there are also glorious, you know, possibilities out there. Adhiraj.
इंडिया में काफ़ी, जैसे जो गांव होते हैं, छोटे शहर्स होते हैं, काफ़ी सारे लोग हैं जिनके पास बैंक अकाउंट्स नहीं है, राइट? उनके पास क्रेडिट कार्ड्स नहीं है, बैंक अकाउंट्स नहीं है, एंड टू गेट एक्सेस टू सर्विसेज इज रियली डिफिकल्ट, राइट? इफ द ओनली थिंग दैट यू हैव इज अ स्मार्टफोन, इट्स रियली हार्ड टू गेट क्रेडिट, इट्स रियली हार्ड टू गेट बैंक लोन्स, इट्स रियली हार्ड टू बाय, यू नो, बाय अ हाउस, ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स. And so the real opportunity that crypto brings is, and this has been something that's experienced in El Salvador, in South Salvador, where they made Bitcoin legal tender, is now, as a country, 90% of the population has a Bitcoin wallet. And because it's legal tender, all of a sudden, without needing a bank account or a credit card or a credit score, you can now get loans, you can now get financing, you can start businesses, you can, you know, explore and do things that you wouldn't be able to do otherwise. We have a whole industry of people, you know, artists, scientists, creatives, who earlier couldn't make money, right? Like if you're an artist, you were going and trying to sell your paintings and maybe getting into an art auction or doing something, right? Today, you can create your painting, you can upload it online, and someone will buy it somewhere else in the world without even meeting you, and you can make that money that is a meaningful amount of money for you to live off and do things with, right? So crypto's created an opportunity where you can transact and do things with people all around the world from your computer somewhere in India and not having to worry about, you know, how that money gets there.
Our panelists today have done a fabulous job. They've given us an entirely holistic perspective, while on one hand, there is a lot of euphoria. On the other hand, there is relative danger as well. Pick carefully, choose carefully, and grow. I think that's the mantra that all panelists are going to leave you with today. On behalf of the panel, I thank you all, my wonderful audience, for being part of this panel discussion. I'm hoping you've taken back a lot of cautious optimism from this panel discussion and hoping that the crypto wave brings you loads of success in the future. Thank you so much, and thank you for joining us.
So I did tell you that this will be an extremely exciting panel, and it was. Great to have you all on board, and many thanks for taking out time from your busy schedule to join us today. So before we move on, first let's have a look at what the general public has to say about cryptocurrency.
आजकल ऐसी बहुत सी apps आ गई हैं जिनके जरिए कोई भी cryptocurrency में invest कर सकता है. India में cryptocurrency में investment बहुत तेजी से बढ़ रहा है. 6 महीने पहले तक तो शायद ही कोई crypto के बारे में जानता था.
जब तक सरकार की कोई गाइडलाइंस नहीं आ जाती तब तक तो मैं यही कहूंगा कि हमें सोच समझकर क्रिप्टोकरेंसी में इन्वेस्ट करना चाहिए. जल्दी कमाने के चक्कर में भारी नुकसान भी हो सकता है.
क्रिप्टोकरेंसी भी शेयर मार्केट की तरह होती है, भाव ऊपर नीचे होते हैं, लेकिन शेयर खरीदने बेचने के लिए भारत में सरकार की गाइडलाइंस है. क्रिप्टो में ऐसा नहीं है, इसलिए इस पर ध्यान से इन्वेस्ट करना चाहिए.
क्रिप्टोकरेंसी के बारे में सुना तो बहुत था, लेकिन अब देख भी रहे हैं. मेरे बहुत से दोस्तों ने इसमें इन्वेस्ट भी किया है और वो ठीक ठाक कमा भी रहे हैं.
सुनने में तो ये भी आ रहा है कि प्राइवेट डिजिटल क्रिप्टोकरेंसी बैन हो सकती है और सरकार अपनी यानी कि सरकारी डिजिटल क्रिप्टोकरेंसी लाने पर विचार भी कर रही है.
मैं तो बिटकॉइन का रेट सुनकर हिल गया, 50 लाख का एक बिटकॉइन. हालांकि सारे क्रिप्टोकरेंसी इतनी महंगी नहीं होती, कुछ कॉइन्स का रेट तो शायद 1 रुपए से भी कम है.
We would like to thank our presenting partner CoinSwitch Kuber, our co-powered by partners Crypto and BitPNS, and our special partner PNP Coins, world's first regulated cryptocurrency. With that, now it's time for us to move on to our third and final panel discussion of the day. This panel will discuss the current state and future of NFTs. Non-fungible tokens, or NFTs, are digital blockchain tokens that reflect ownership of one-of-a-kind digital or physical asset. NFTs can symbolize a variety of things, including real estate, art, music, and even whiskey casks. Because each NFT is unique, they differ from fungible assets or currencies, such as bitcoins or rupees, in which each unit can be exchanged for another. While the first NFTs were created in 2012-13, they have only recently gained mainstream attention. NFTs strive to be authentic and unique, which is a significant value proposition. A limited edition signed a poster by an actor or sports person is a fair analog to the traditional world. The value of the poster lies not in the underlying image alone, but in the fact that the celebrity has supported it. Although just once or twice, NFTs are also a step ahead since they can be programmed using smart contracts, allowing for the automation of a range of formerly manual processes. So joining us for this highly informative and engaging session today are Arjit Sinha, first Indian multimedia journalist, filmmaker to cover crypto, Bitcoin globally. Arjit has a diverse, innovative and versatile work experience as a content director for more than 7 years. He has worked with some world-leading digital video platforms, brands, news media, social organizations and covered international assignments, mostly in South Asia, and Europe. He has worked in all formats including print, TV, digital media and virtual reality. He has a keen eye for new media trends, content, innovative strategies and gadgets which can be used to tell exceptional stories. He is also the first Indian to cover cryptocurrencies, blockchain globally and write about blockchain-based digital currencies. He believes in his philosophy of one's passion can lead to everyone's success. So joining Arshad in this session is Satvik Sethi, mental health activist, social impact leader, NFT enthusiast, investor and collector. A highly motivated and ambitious 23-year-old with an undying hunger for learning. His hobbies and interests include public speaking, social activism, strategy consulting, and UI/UX design. He is passionate about mental health education, healthcare systems, emerging technologies, and global cultures. He is the recipient of Mental Health America's Empower Award 2020 and featured on the Under 25 Social Entrepreneurs list by Impaction and a culture media company. He has been recognized as one of 8 inspiring mental health youth activists by Mashable and one of 15 students changing collegiate. Mental Health by Mental Health America for the impact he has created through his passionate advocacy. Joining Arshad and Satvik on this panel is Bethanavel Kupuswamy, co-founder at MetaTribe and building fan communities on Web3. Ex-Ola, Byju's, IIT Madras. Bethanavel is a tech entrepreneur building fan engagement platform leveraging NFTs and social tokens. Previously, he built data analytics solution for movie businesses and had worked with Ola Cabs and Baidu's during their early days. He graduated from his engineering program at IIT Madras in 2014. Also joining this panel is Gaurav Dhake, CEO BitPayNS, a passionate techie and an entrepreneur at heart with the ability to build and lead high-performance teams. Previously involved with analyzing socioeconomic predicaments for populace around Kharagpur and devising self-sustainable solutions when functioning as an executive officer of an NGO, GYWS. And finally moderating this panel is Ishan Sukul, expert in consumer growth, ex-Bain, VC, Uno, Comma Club. Ishan Sukul, a builder and a problem solver at heart. These are the core pillars which got him hooked to Web3. Having been introduced to Ethereum in 2017 while conducting due diligence on firms to invest in during his VC stint, he has been fondly attached to the space ever since. Apart from being an amateur investor, he specifically has a keen interest in DeFi and DAOs. He has also previously worked on a few of his own experiments in the NFT space while tinkering on a product idea for the same. So let's join this panel to know more about NFTs.
Hello everyone, this is Ishan and welcome to Zee's webinar on the crypto series. And today we're going to be talking about a very prevalent topic about NFTs, non-fungible tokens. ये आपने काफी सुना होगा आजकल के न्यूज़ में क्रिकेटर्स के आ रहे हैं NFTs, अमिताभ बच्चन के NFTs आ रहे हैं, सलमान खान के NFTs आ रहे हैं. But NFTs होते क्या exactly is something which we're going to try to figure out today. And we have 4 to 5 really relevant people from the industry जो हमें सिखाएंगे कि NFT होते क्या हैं. And what do they mean? मतलब इनका चारा क्या है, आधे करेंसी, आधे टू बी यूज्ड एज कलेक्टिबल्स, व्हाट आर दे टू बी यूज्ड एज, वी विल गेट टू नो टुडे. सो आई थिंक आई विल स्टार्ट ऑफ द सेशन विद सात्विक. सात्विक हैज बीन इन द एनएफटी स्पेस फॉर अ व्हाइल, बट सात्विक आई'd लव टू हियर फ्रॉम यू कि व्हाट डज एनएफटी स्टैंड फॉर एग्जैक्टली, व्हाट डज इट मीन एंड हाउ डू दे वर्क.
सबसे बेसिक सेंस में एक सर्टिफिकेट है जो ऑथेंटिसिटी को प्रूव करता है. सो थिंक ऑफ इट एज यूनिक स्टोर्स ऑफ डेटा ऑन अ डिजिटल लेजर जिसको हम ब्लॉकचेन बोलते हैं. तो NFTs को भी समझने से पहले हमें पहले वर्ड फंजिबल जो नॉन फंजिबल टोकन में आता है उसको समझना जरूरी है. सो फंजिबल मीन्स कि जब आप एक 100 रुपए का नोट लेके जाते हैं तो शॉपकीपर के लिए 100 रुपए का नोट टू द अदर इट्स द सेम थिंग. सिमिलरली डिजिटल करेंसीज में इथेरियम और बिटकॉइन, वन इथेरियम टू द अदर इज इनडिस्टिंग्विशेबल व्हिच मीन्स दे आर फंजिबल. उनकी इंट्रिंसिक वैल्यू सेम है बट इन द सेंस ऑफ NFTs they are non-fungible, which means you can't distinguish one or you can distinguish one NFT from the other because they have a unique metadata that underlines this NFT. So, aajkal, like you were saying, NFTs have become a digital collectible artwork with cricketers or actors. Yet, even though they look similar from one NFT to the other, even identical visually, there is still uniqueness that can be easily verified, which separates them from each other. And the reason that digital collectibles have been doing so well and have become one of the biggest reasons why NFTs has gone mainstream is because, unlike traditionally where people used to buy art, you had to involve a third party who would come and verify ki aapne jo artwork khareeda hai ye asli artist se hai, iski history kya hai. When it comes to NFTs, the proof of ownership is built into the NFT itself. So any collector of any level can easily verify without the middleman ki ye kis artist ne banaya hai, kab banaya hai, iske details kya hai, some metadata kya hai. And it is also good for the artists who are creating these NFTs because now they can have ownership over their work. They don't need any middleman service jo unke art ko collectors tak leke jayega. And most importantly, they also earn royalties. So agar aapne kisi ko artwork becha but unhone 10 saal baad wo artwork kisi aur ko becha hai, so as the creator of that work, you still get royalties on that and you continue to get it in perpetuity.
I'd like to take this to Archit, and since Archit has been in the creator space for quite some time and has been into collectibles, I'd like to understand the evolution of collectibles, especially with respect to NFTs. How is it any different from physical art?
So I guess the collectibles go a long way back, right? When we used to collect stamps, tokens, you know, we used to collect shoes or, you know, the tadzos, you know. सो कलेक्टेबल्स की अगर आप हिस्ट्री देखोगे तो ये बहुत पुराना है, राइट? यू नो व्हाई इट्स सो डिफरेंट इज, यू नो, गेटिंग दिस पेंटिंग फ्रॉम आर्ट म्यूजियम और समथिंग, यू नो, बिकॉज दे यूज टू टेक अ 40% कट, राइट? एंड दिस होल क्रेजीनेस राइट नाउ अराउंड NFTs इज बिकॉज नाउ देयर इज एन ऑनलाइन इकोनॉमी. नाउ देयर इज एन इकोनॉमी फॉर दोज कलेक्टेबल्स, राइट? अर्लियर यू नेवर हैड एन इकोनॉमी फॉर कलेक्टेबल्स ऑनलाइन. Which means if I am putting up a picture as an NFT, I am not selling the picture. I'm selling the digital rights of that picture. Now that becomes a collectible, right? And even if you take the case of museums, right? They used to the paintings. Now imagine if there is a local artist, let's say in the state of Bihar, and if he puts it out as NFT, right? Now, I mean, that art is lying, you know, kind of vacant because nobody's buying it out. Now he can go online and kind of put it out as an art. And he's selling his, you know, the property rights of that painting or that art, right? And that is where you see all these crypto kitties, whether it's Beeple, you know, whether rising Indian artists, whether you see somebody from the, you know, music industry now going there. Now, the thing is with YouTube and everything, you know, there's a viral video, you know, I'm just diverting my way towards YouTube because, you know, that's because it's more of a creator space. Now, the viral video is something which we were never used to back in 2007, you know. And now coming back to the collectibles, I see it as in the future of equal significance, you know. So dating back to all those collection of stamps, you know, kind of pictures, GIFs. Now it's all going online and I think they have a value to it. So that's where I think the collectibles have graduated from that historic stamps to these GIFs. And I think I see a huge market for this. And that's how I see the transition. And it's going to be more evolving, right? Right now, it's still in a nascent stage. It'll have a better user interface. You know, Rarible just came out with a recent feature of messaging yesterday. I was just reading about it. You know, Royal is a music platform which has just launched up. So I guess it's still an evolving process, but I see a big future. And yes, ab in collectibles ka jo hai ek value hai online. So yeah.
हम ये जानना चाहेंगे कि शुरू कौन हुआ, वेयर डिड दिस स्टार्ट एंड व्हाट इज व्हाट मेड दिस किक ऑफ, क्या कंपनी से स्टार्ट हुआ, क्या एंटिटी से स्टार्ट हुआ और क्यों शुरू हुआ?
सो टू गिव यू अ ब्रीफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ एनएफटीज एज सच, द इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग इज इट्स नॉट अ वेरी रीसेंट थिंग, इट डेट्स बैक एज पर एज अर्ली एज 2012 राइट, व्हेन पीपल स्टार्टेड यूजिंग बिटकॉइन ब्लॉकचेन टू you know, to register ownership of real world assets on the blockchain. So that's how, you know, the whole tokenization of real world assets started. And it was only in 2016 or 17 when like interesting projects like CryptoPunks or CryptoKitties started kicking off. That's when it became like even more interesting, because then the community started getting involved. Like, you know, where, you know, gaming communities or meme communities, so they started getting involved and they gave a whole new meaning to digital collectibles and you know, the whole because it is rare, why it is valuable, and because the community gave that meaning to them, right? So CryptoKitties is nothing but, you know, it's a game where, you know, you adopt or breed and transact virtual cats and stuff like that, and went really viral, right? So after that point, actually, even till that whole thing was around crypto communities, gaming communities, and it was only during early this year it became sort of mainstream, right? Especially the when the artist called Beeple sold his video for $69 million, right? So that's when sort of became mainstream, and a lot of people, including various artists, started looking up to NFTs as one of the ways by which they can make income and all of that. And especially after they were impacted by COVID and the lockdowns, so they started seeing NFT as one of the ways by which they can reconnect with the community and, you know, generate income and all of that.
Point kya NFTs ka? Why? I'd love to hear this from Gaurav ki, from a collector, buyer, creator standpoint, kya point hai inka? And value kaise dete hain products ko?
सो एन एफ टी को अगर देखा जाए राइट, कोई भी चीज़ को वैल्यू उस सेंस में मिलती है, आई काइंड ऑफ एट्रीब्यूट इट टू ह्यूमन अटेंशन स्पैन राइट. तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इवन मीम कॉइन्स जैसे थे, शिबा इनू हो गया, डॉज कॉइन हो गया, इनको वैल्यू क्यों मिलती है? क्योंकि दे आर वैल्यूएबल फॉर अ सर्टन सेट ऑफ पीपल हु काइंड ऑफ ट्रांजैक्ट इन देम, ट्रेड इन दिटीज. एंड similar to that, right, some things might not be valuable for you, but if they are capturing the human attention span of certain set of people, and that is a community which kind of thrives, then it starts getting attention and value. So think of it this way, a Louis Vuitton bag might not be relevant for you, but it might be relevant for certain sort of group of females, and that basically makes your bag 1 lakh mein bhi khareedne ko taiyar ho. So ye cheez hoti hai, NFT is social contract between the creator and the set of individuals that it is kind of being kind of talked about with. On-chain uska ek ownership ascribe hota hai. To on-chain matlab Ethereum pe ho sakta hai, baki aur blockchains pe ho sakta hai. Ethereum being the most dominant blockchain around that. Pehla NFT is CryptoKitties ke through aaya tha. Kyun value create hoti hai? Iska main ek chota sa example deke explain karne ki koshish karunga. To jaise assume ki painting hai. आपके घर पे अगर मोनालिसा की पेंटिंग है, आप उसको एक साल में 300, 400, 500 लोगों को दिखा पाओगे, घर पे बुलाकर वो दिखा सकते हो कि ये. बट अगर आप ये डिजिटली प्रूव कर सकते हो कि आपके पास मोनालिसा की पेंटिंग है, वो आप लाखों लोगों को सोशल मीडिया के जरिए या बाकी माध्यम के जरिए बता सकते हैं. दैट इज द सॉर्ट ऑफ डिफरेंस दैट वो जो स्टेटस सिंबल है या फिर वो शोकेस है, वो आप मोर प्रोमिनेंटली कर सकते हो डिजिटली. तो जहाँ पे मोस्ट ऑफ अस स्पेंड मोर टाइम नाउ, विच इज़ नॉट ट्रू से 15 इयर्स बैक, बट मोस्ट ऑफ अस स्पेंड 8-10 आवर्स ऑफ स्क्रीन टाइम एवरी सिंगल डे नाउ. तो ये जो चीज़ चेंज हुआ है, तो NFT उसमें उस माध्यम के लिए काफ़ी इंटरेस्टिंग ओनरशिप पीसेस है. एंड ये चीज़ कैसे वैल्यू गेन करते हैं राइट, जो कलेक्टर है या फिर जो यूज़र है या फिर कोई फैन है, वो NFT को वैल्यू एसोसिएट करते हैं. NFTs value तब gain करते हैं जब उन्हें display किया जाता है, use किया जाता है, promote किया जाता है कोई एक certain community में, right? तो वो जो सर्टन कम्युनिटी काइंड ऑफ एस्क्राइब्स इट, सो फॉर एग्जांपल someone in Brazil might have zero relevance for, say, the NFT of Dhoni holding the World Cup, right? And I would have, say, very low relevance for someone who is in Brazil, who is, say, a footballer or something. But us community mein what kind of keeps differing, wo cheez human attention span ko basic atomic level pe soch sakte ho. And that is how NFTs gain value, attain value, grow in value and kind of get ascribed.
Ab it's important to know ki ye, how is NFT even related to all of this? What's the correlation between crypto, blockchain and NFTs? I think we'll hear it from Satvik, the NFT expert himself.
So that's a good question in terms of what the correlation actually is. And so at the most basic fundamental level, you need crypto for the most part to start buying NFTs. And you know, NFTs are actually just another use case that was derived from the crypto world. So when you think of Ethereum, Ethereum was created as a digital currency almost, both an investment mechanism and something that you can spend. But the reason why Ethereum became such an important aspect of NFTs is because Ethereum introduced smart contracts, which were basically a way for developers and creators to start interacting with NFTs at a higher level than just as a currency, and actually introduce some sort of building blocks on it to start creating other things. And so with smart contracts, now people can create NFTs, which, you know, one, you obviously have the proof of ownership and the certificate of authenticity, but then you can also have multiple other things. So you can introduce royalties, you can introduce the descriptions, the metadata, all of that stuff. So that's one aspect of it. But with that said, obviously you don't need cryptocurrencies only to buy NFTs. One of the biggest changes that we're seeing now in the NFT space is that in order to bring the masses, which is, you know, jo bhi ye sun rahe, agar aapne kabhi cryptocurrency nahi khareedi, aapka exchange pe kisi cryptocurrency exchange pe account nahi hai, तब भी आपके लिए NFT खरीदने में कोई रुकावट नहीं आनी चाहिए. एंड दैट इज वन क्रिटिकल स्टेप वेयर वी कैन ब्रिंग दिस टू द मास्टर्स विदाउट हैविंग देम ऑन बोर्ड इनटू क्रिप्टो.
ये सारे डिजिटल कॉपीज होते हैं, कैन आई जस्ट राइट क्लिक एंड मेक माय कॉपी ऑफ एन NFT? इस केस में आईपी कौन ओन करता है, मतलब हाउ डज इट वर्क?
गुड क्वेश्चन. Now see, when I first time, when I, you know, kind of saw the NFT platform, like that's the same question which was in my head, right? So, I mean, many people wonder, you know, can't I screenshot the NFT without purchasing? You know, forget about right clicking. I mean, can't I just screenshot the NFT? You know, but this is true, but you would not be able to sell it at the value of original price. You know what I mean? You know, you need to kind of put it for sale. And, you know, you might want to take a screenshot, but you would not be able to sell it at the value of the original. Now, similarly, if you take a photo of, you know, let's say the painting, let's say the Mona Lisa painting, it would be challenging to find a collector. So every time the NFT moves on to the secondary market, right, the new owner and the price paid is automatically recorded on the blockchain. Wo automatically record hoga blockchain pe. And that's why the technology of blockchain exists, you know, which is a digital archive of transactions, which nobody can alter and everyone can see.
Now, next, I think, chalo, theek hai, we made these NFTs, we're storing it somewhere, but are these even safe? Can I lose them? Ye internet mein hai. Matlab, is it possible to lose them?
To answer that question, like, you know, one thing I would like to say is it's very difficult to lose NFT, you know. So, like Archit was pointing out, the whole data is stored on blockchain. Like, so I think firstly we need to understand how exactly NFT is stored. Like, first thing is the metadata about the NFT, like who is the creator and who is the current owner of the NFT, or what price it's trading, or the trading history, the number of editions it may have. So all these data are stored on blockchain. This is the metadata of the NFT. For example, if you're buying a digital art, it could be a JPEG image. The image is not necessarily saved on blockchain. The metadata surrounding the image, about the image, is saved on blockchain. And the image as such is saved elsewhere. So most commonly used is IPFS, which is Interplanetary File System, which is a peer-to-peer network where files are saved or shared in a decentralized manner. Right. So one advantage of that is, for example, if a centralized database has the NFT, it's typically owned by a company or an organization. And if, for example, if it goes, if shut down or something like that happens, the database also goes down along with that. So you lose the NFT. So by putting it on decentralized database like IPFS, you are basically securing the files also.
Now let's talk more about ki aajkal ka hype kya hai. Current state kya NFTs ka? Why is there so much of a hype? The reason why we are having this webinar also is to understand ki itna zyada hype kyun hai, itni sare discussions kya ho rahi hain. And I'd like to have Gaurav to give us an answer on that. And at the same time, Gaurav would also like to know if there's some plans with Bitbins and Bitdroplet also at some point doing something here.
We've been kind of exploring the NFT space. NFTs ke around hype ka reason wahi hota hai ki कोई भी टेक्नोलॉजी के इन्फ्लेक्शन पॉइंट के बाद बहुत उसमें यूजर्स जल्दी आने लगते हैं, राइट? सो इवन एवरी सिंगल डे देयर आर मोर पीपल एंड अप जॉइनिंग क्रिप्टो और हर लेवल पे, नॉट जस्ट रिटेल, इंस्टीट्यूशन, पेंशन फंड्स, हेज फंड, सारे लेवल्स पे ये चीज़ हो रही है, इवन कंट्रीज एज अ होल, राइट? सो दैट इज अबाउट दैट ट्रू इवन विद एनएफटीज. एनएफटीज वर क्रिएटेड मच अर्लियर, 2012-13 कुछ था अलग अलग प्लेटफॉर्म्स पे, फिर इथेरियम 2016 में क्रिप्टो किटीज वगैरह के थ्रू हुआ. अब इन्फ्लेक्शन पॉइंट आ गया है एंड देयर आर लॉट ऑफ पीपल गेटिंग एनएफटीज. देयर आर लॉट ऑफ फैशन प्लस हॉलीवुड प्लस आर्ट सॉर्ट ऑफ गेटिंग इन द मिक्स ऑफ एनएफटीज एंड काइंड ऑफ डूइंग थिंग्स. तो वो एक अडॉप्शन वहां से आता है जहां पे व्हेन क्रिटिकल सॉर्ट ऑफ पीपल गेट इन्वॉल्वड एंड दे काइंड ऑफ स्टार्ट पुशिंग थिंग्स अराउंड दैट.
Very interesting. Or aap, matlab, are you planning on doing something in this space as well?
Yeah, so we have been like, kind of working on something. So we'll kind of announce it soon. Explore kar rahe hai. I think there is a need for another sort of NFT platform. There are already dozens and all. We're trying to kind of innovate as we always do. Ki jaise bit droplet banaye hai, fir bahut sare alag alag cheeze humne banayi. To NFTs mein kya unique ho sakta hai, kya users ko value add karega. India mein NFTs utna popular abhi hua nahi hai. We don't even do 0.5% of the global transaction volume of NFTs. So what can we do to increase that point?
So projects choose karna, how do you even know ki matlab kuch sahi chal raha hai, nahi chal raha. So Satvik has been collecting for quite some time, and Satvik, I know you have a collection of more than 400 or 500 NFTs. So Satvik, I'd like to hear from you. Who are the current stalwarts? How does someone pick a project also? So, and how have they been faring? You have been invested in this for quite some time now. So I'd like to get your opinion on that.
Some people are builders, like some of the people here, you know, building businesses or building companies, ventures, platforms around NFTs. There are some people who are collectors like me, who just want to play a role by collecting and, you know, participating in the NFT economy. And then we have investors who are venture capitalists, angel investors who just want to invest money to see this economy grow. So that's one side of it. And then when you think about the actual NFT community, the economy, obviously the biggest players are the NFT marketplaces that essentially enable the entire commerce for NFTs. You know, you need these marketplaces to be able to buy, trade, sell, even create NFTs.
काफ़ी सारे प्लेटफॉर्म्स अभी निकलते जा रहे हैं. स्पीकर्स जो आज थे, दे आर ऑल डूइंग देयर ओन प्रोजेक्ट्स एज वेल, एंड आई एम क्वाइट एक्साइटेड टू सी हाउ इट इवॉल्व्स. सो या आई थिंक आई'd लाइक टू एंड द सेशन ऑन दिस नोट. एंड डू योर ओन रिसर्च, पता करो कि कैसे चलता है. एंड यप, आई थिंक दैट्स अबाउट इट. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर व्यूइंग दिस.
Many thanks to all the panelists and speakers for joining us today. It has indeed been a day full of learnings and insights, and I am sure we will all be eagerly waiting for the next installment of the event. Just a quick parting thought. One question that might arise in the mind of our viewers is whether cryptocurrencies can play a monetary role in the sense of how effectively they perform the three traditional functions of money, namely medium of exchange, store of value, and unit of account. Fulfilling the role of medium of exchange is a relatively simple criteria that any good, digital or physical, product is capable of fulfilling. In this sense, cryptocurrencies have succeeded in filling this role because they are all traded on market exchanges and may be quickly transferred between owners. The more intriguing monetary problems for cryptos concern their potential to perform the other two functions of money, store of value, and unit of account. With these still unanswered questions and a little food for thought, it is time for us to say goodbye. We will see you all soon with more thought-provoking discussions built around the topic of finance and technology. Till then, take care, stay safe, and keep inventing new scenarios to make this world a better place. We would like to thank our presenting partner, CoinSwitch Kuber, our co-powered by partners, Crypto and BitPNS, and our special partner, PNP Coins, world's first regulated cryptocurrency.